Let's consider some barriers to trade. Almost always, barriers are imposed against imports rather than exports, and there are two primary ways of doing it. One is by imposing a tariff, which is a tax on imports, and the other is a quota, which is a limit on the quantity imported. If within a given market, the equilibrium price without trade is greater than the world price for that good, then once the country opens up to trade, they will import that good. Specifically, domestic consumers will always want to purchase the good at the cheapest price available. So for the first segment, for the first few units, they will prefer to purchase from domestic producers until foreign producers offer the good for a lower price, at which point domestic consumers purchase from foreign producers as long as their willingness to pay is still above that price. So this will be the quantity that domestic consumers buy. This will be the quantity that domestic producers sell. And the difference between them will be imports. And the same picture applies here. What is a tariff? A tariff is a tax that applies only to foreign goods. So remember, we said we can think of a tax as an increase in the marginal cost of production. So what that meant usually was that a tax shifted the supply curve up by the amount of the tax. A tariff is exactly the same, except that it only applies to the foreign supply. So a tariff T per unit will have the effect of increasing the price of foreign goods faced by domestic consumers by the amount T. So now domestic consumers will be able to buy foreign goods only at PW plus T. And this will be the foreign supply from their perspective. What effect will that have? Well, consumers will be able to purchase less. And they'll have to pay a higher price for it. However, more of that will be bought from domestic producers. So now the amount of imports is smaller. So the tariff does achieve the goal of reducing imports and increasing how much domestic producers sell. However, we're also facing the consequence that domestic consumers purchase less and have to pay more for the good. So domestic consumer surplus decreases relative to the free trade case. Domestic producer surplus increases relative to free trade. Specifically, the loss in consumer surplus is this trapezoid. The gain in domestic producer surplus is this trapezoid. This area in the middle is lost to consumers but not recovered by producers. However, part of it goes to tariff revenues. So tariff revenues are collected by the domestic government. They're proportional to imports. For each of the units still imported, we're adding the amount T to domestic coffers. So this area is tariff revenue. Where's that coming from? Well, it's coming directly from the lost consumer surplus of domestic consumers. These are units that consumers were buying before and are still buying now that there's a tariff. However, they're paying more for each one of those units. So once again, the total surplus now that we've imposed the tariff is smaller for consumers, bigger for producers. Part of that loss is recovered as tariff revenue, so tax revenue essentially. However, these two small areas are simply lost. These are not recovered in any form. Where do these come from? Why is there economic loss in this case? It actually helps to think of them separately. This small area is proportional to the number of units that the consumers no longer purchase. Right? Consumers had to cut back on how much they bought when the tariff was introduced. And so for each one of those units, what is lost is the fact that consumers were willing to pay more for each than it cost to produce them abroad. So there's a potential gain that is not realized anymore. So this economic surplus loss is due to lost consumption. There's another segment here, there's another area that denotes economic loss, and this is proportional to the number of units that used to be imported but is now produced domestically. There is surplus loss here because foreign producers were able to make that good more cheaply than domestic producers. Domestic producers have this cost per unit. Foreign producers had the cost of PW per unit. So for each one of those, that vertical distance added is extra cost that's incurred in production domestically versus abroad. So it's an economic surplus loss that's due to inefficient production as opposed to lost consumption. Import quotas work very similarly to tariffs. Again, the initial picture is the same as we were drawing here. So we have a quantity consumed by domestic consumers and the quantity produced by domestic firms. And the difference between them was a quantity of imports. A quota will say, well, you can't import this much, you can only import some smaller amount. We could show it as a horizontal segment because we have quantity on the horizontal axis. So let's say that the restriction is as indicated here. So foreign supply is restricted to only spanning this horizontal distance. There are multiple ways of showing it in the graph. The easiest way to look at it is as follows. Suppose that we're now restricting how much can be imported to this smaller amount. Well, an immediate consequence of that is that there will be remaining domestic consumers who want to purchase more at the world price than are imports allowed. So what will they do whenever there's a shortage? In this case, it would be a shortage of foreign goods. Well, consumers will bid up the price. They will be willing to offer more in order to still be able to buy the foreign good. How much will price go up? It will go up by the amount necessary so that the amount imported of the good exactly equals the demand for the foreign good. So we will arrive at some new price of foreign goods on this market so that the amount of imports exactly equals the quota. the more restrictive the quota, the smaller this amount, the higher the price of foreign goods will be bid on this market. What will be the consequence for domestic consumers and producers? It will be very similar to what happens when there's a tariff. So consumers domestically will have to pay a higher price for the goods they purchase, and they'll purchase a smaller amount, so their surplus will be reduced. Domestic producers will be able to sell more and charge a higher price, so they will benefit the same way that they do with import tariffs. There is, however, a key difference, and that is with an import tariff, the domestic government is able to collect some revenue. With an import quota, there is no such revenue. Instead, for each of these units that is still brought into the country, the fact that the price at which they're sold is greater than the world price means that for each one of those units, there's a net gain to the foreign producers. So this area will now go, rather than to tariff revenue, will form producer surplus for foreign suppliers. So foreign producer surplus.